Hello, everyone. My name is Lashia Daniels. I'm an 11th grader at Baltimore City College. I'm 16 years old, and there's my little sister in the background. What I'm going to talk to you about today, I hope you like, and it's been interesting. I'm going to talk about what makes a person, regardless of any situation. First, I'm going to start off with me, myself. I feel as though the things that I have went through in my life, you know, such as peer pressure or, you know, or being insecure about myself or worrying about what people think and how I overcame it, it made me into the person that I am today. And that knowing that negative situations that took place in your life, such as the little things like what people say about you, do not make you or break you. You have to learn how to be yourself regardless of the flaws that you have. And as you can see, you may see some of the flaws. Right now, you may see that I have bumps on my face, on my cheeks, and stuff like that. My head is very big or whatever. But I don't look at it like that. Hey, I put on makeup to match my bumps. It doesn't even matter. Don't care. Because I know I'm beautiful, and that's how I feel about myself. And when I look in the mirror at myself every day, I look past all of that because I know that I'm a good person and that God has blessed me to be the person that I am. I have many talents. I can sing, I can dance, I can draw. I'm very smart and very intelligent. Instead of looking at the things that you don't like about yourself, think about something that you do. Think about something that you do like about yourself. Think about the things that are good about you. The good things that people say about you. Block out all of the things that the negative things that people have said about you. I remember one time I was on the bus and two boys were behind me. It just happened to be the day that I chose to wear khaki high waters or whatever. I don't even know how I wore that because I have clothes. I have a lot of stuff, you know. Not that material things really matter to me. They were sitting behind me and one of them was like, look at her. She thinks she cool because, I mean, when I walk, I walk with confidence. It doesn't matter what I'm wearing that day. My hair could be in a nappy ponytail or in a bush or whatever. It may not be my best day, but regardless of how I look or whatever day it is, I'm still going to walk with confidence and I'm going to walk with my head held high because that's the kind of person that I am. I have confidence in myself and I love myself and I know that I'm beautiful regardless of any situation. I remember I was sitting on the bus and two of them behind me like, she thinks she cool, didn't think I hear me, whatever. Look at her, she got high waters on though. Look at them boots, she got high waters on, da da da. She thinks she this, she thinks she that, da da da. And then saying stuff about, oh, but that's what they said. And I was just listening to everything that they were saying. And it kind of got to me, I ain't gonna lie, but I had to think about it though. Okay, whatever. I'm wearing khaki high waters, which, to be honest with you, I never wore those before. I just slept it on. But it doesn't matter about that. And then you just talking about how girls are dirty and how they don't keep themselves up. They always saying bad things about girls, like bees this, bees that. You know, they're calling them female dogs and stuff like that. I don't even like to cuss. But when I was sitting there listening to that on the bus, it kind of hurt my feelings. But then when I went home and I thought about it, like, regardless of how you look, people are going to always have things to say about you. People say things about Selena Gomez. People say things about Miley Cyrus and Demi Lovato on Twitter and on Facebook. People say things about Mary J. Blige, about Beyonce, saying that Beyonce thinks she's this, she thinks she's that, or she believes in the devil and all this crazy stuff. People always come up with stuff to say about you. And just to think about my personality and who I am, there's been many times when I felt insecure about myself and worrying about what people think. But then as I grew and those situations that took place in my life about what people said about me and all that crazy stuff, I mean, I became stronger. Now people can say things about me and I just brush it off. It'll go in this ear and out the other. And it doesn't even matter. Then you have things about boys. When they're saying things about girls and what turns them on and turns them off. Oh, she has to learn how to cook or she has to be light skinned or she has to be dark skinned. She has to be this, she has to be that. Or her shoes have to be fresh or she has to be pretty. Da, da, da. She don't even have to be wearing all that makeup. I'm not saying I really don't need makeup. I feel that I don't need makeup. I mean, I still feel beautiful if I'm wearing makeup or not wearing makeup. But all in all, why should it matter about all those things? If you like a girl, you should like her for who she is, not for what she wears and how she looks. It should be about the personality. It's more to a female than the way she looks. There's a lot of things about her. personality, the way she carries herself, the way she walks, the way she talks, her swagger, whatever you want to call it, her style, whatever you want to call it, you know, is more to just her style. But me, every day, I'll be honest with you, the kind of person that I am, I walk by myself every day. I don't have any boyfriends, and even though it's nobody's business, but I'm a virgin, and I choose to stay a virgin until I get married. And I feel as though I don't need a boy in my life to make me feel happy and to feel beautiful and all of that. I look in the mirror at myself every day. You know what I say? I say, Lashia Daniels, you are beautiful. I look at my bumps. Your bumps are beautiful too. That's how I feel. That's how I cry. You know, I walk through the halls every day by myself. I'm like the shortest person. I'm not even 5 feet yet. And I walk through the halls. People walk past me. They move out my way because they know that I exist and that I am a person. And they see that I respect myself, so they respect me. You know, and if you don't have any respect for yourself, how do you expect people to respect you? You know, and I had to learn something like that. It started off when I first went to Summer Bridge to go to Baltimore City College, because I am now an 11th grader at Baltimore City College. And people used to pick on me and say things about me. And I failed to realize that I didn't have any confidence in myself, and I didn't love myself, and I didn't accept myself who I am. Even my flaws and even my strengths and my weaknesses, I didn't accept it. Keep in mind that I was very talented. I knew how to sing, I knew how to dance, draw. I can do a lot of things. I can model, I can act. I can do a lot of things. You know, I'm very good, I'm very talented, but people see that, but people then see that I was insecure about myself, so they begin to pick on me, like, okay, she's quiet, she's still herself, so maybe I should just pick on her and do whatever I want to do to her. But then as I got in the 10th grade, I became more out there. I started singing more, and I started doing things that I love to do and trying to block out things about what people think about me. Now I'm in 11th grade, and I mean, I do stupid stuff sometimes. Sometimes I act crazy. I might run around and people may look at me like I'm stupid. But I brush it off because everybody has something that somebody has to say about them. Regardless, everybody has flaws. Everybody has something that somebody can crack on them about. I mean, everybody has flaws. Nobody's perfect. Nobody came into this world made perfect, you know? Regardless if you're a Christian, an atheist, or whatever. I mean, nobody's perfect. Everybody has something bad about themselves. But all I want to say is, when it comes to personality, a lot of things are required. You know, you have to be, first of all, to be a good person, to have a great personality, be yourself. Accept yourself who you are, regardless of what flaws you have, or the good things about you, or the bad things about you, your strengths, your weaknesses, whether you're bad in this subject or bad in that subject, whether you got a big head, a small head, a big nose, a big mouth, crooked eyes, it whatever. You are a person, and you were made to be who you are, and you have to accept that. And as I learned to do that, and as I learned to accept myself for who I am, people started to respect me. And keep in mind, people are respecting me now. People respect me for who I am because they see that I carry myself with dignity, and I am honest with myself, and that I accept my flaws. You know, people still say things about me to this day, and they think that I don't hear them. Sometimes I go to the library, and people be talking to me like, oh, you just came from school, huh? Da-da-da-da-da. Look, Miss Perfect this, Miss Perfect that. People are like, who she thinks she is? She thinks she all of that. She ain't as smart as she thinks she is. Well, just because I go to the library every day and I like to read books does not mean that I think I'm smarter than everybody. Does not mean that I think I'm better than everybody. Is there anything wrong with, you know, trying to do something with my life? You know, just be yourself. I don't care. I really don't have any friends. And if you want to be honest, most of the time when I come from school, I go home, I do my homework, go to the library, I type work on the computer, I go home, write my songs, write my music, write my poems, write in my journals, watch TV, talk to my brother, my sister, teach them something, and go to sleep. Wake up the next day, it's the same routine every day. But I don't have any boyfriends, I'm still a virgin, and hey, I walk with my head held high, and people wonder why I act like I do. I'm confident, there's nothing wrong with that. You don't have to be all of these things and be perfect in the magazines and stuff like that to, you know, feel confident in yourself. Because as you can see me now, look at what I'm wearing now. I'm cute. I think I look good. I still keep myself up. It may not be the best clothes, but, you know, I still look good. I wear Abercrombie and Fitch and boots and Aeropostale and Wet Seal. I wear all kinds of stuff. I'm very stylish. And I don't need to have a crowd around me to feel like I'm confident. When I walk, just go back to the subject, is when I walk through the halls when I'm in school. When I walk through the halls, I'm the shortest person. People can barely see me. When they get close up to me, guess what? They move out my way because they know I exist. They be like, oh, excuse me, miss. My bad, miss. They call me miss. You know why? Because I respect myself and I carry myself with dignity. But, you know, it's one thing that I have not ever gotten. People see me. I hear people say, oh, I never really liked light-skinned girls. Or light-skinned girls are so stuck up. They think they this. They think they that. They think they all of that. And I just never understood why people really don't hate light-skinned people. Why do they judge people? Have you ever heard the phrase, don't judge a book by its cover? Just because a person appears to be a certain way does not mean that they are a certain way. You know, people look at me, sometimes I look mean, and they think they just go ahead and assume that I'm mean. I can't help it, that's just the way I look. You know, and I'm not gonna change myself for nobody. And that's one advice I have for you. Don't change yourself for nobody. Don't try to be something that you're not. Be who you are. You know, it's all about being yourself. And that's the main thing about personality, is being yourself. Having confidence. Knowing who you are and accepting your flaws, your strengths and your weaknesses. It's like the third time that I repeated this, but I just wanted to tell you that whether you're dark skin, light skin, orange, brown, or blue, big head, small head, big lips, small lips, big nose, whatever, crooked eyes, it does not matter. It does not matter. You know, you have to accept yourself who you are. And if a person doesn't like you, then they really aren't your friend. And I had to realize that. I really don't have friends. And people wonder why. Why is she always doing work all the time? Why she's always doing this all the time? She's always doing that. You know? Why do people keep saying things about me? Sometimes I wonder. But I just be like, you know what? I don't even care anymore, because I'm going to do me regardless. I'm going to be who I am. And it comes a time in life that sometimes I do feel like I'm wasting my time just doing work, because I don't know if I ever live to see that day to be in the future, just, you know, be something great, like a singer or an architect. But this is one message that I also want to give to you. Don't live for the past and don't live for the future. Just live for the day. It doesn't matter whether you'll live tomorrow or the next day after that. Just do what's right now and do what's right according to your own, your own way of thinking, the way you think, what you want to do. Do what you want until it's time for you to leave this earth. But that's the main thing that I want to say about personality, and I really hope you liked it. Thank you. Bye.